So Tyler, it's a great looking stand of corn we've got back here, fully tasseled. I walked through there, anthers dropping all over the place. What are you seeing across your area?
Well, Tim, I am starting to see some disease pop up. Seeing quite a bit of gray leaf, and then that physoderm brown spot starting to pop up kind of around that ear.
Well, I'm Tim Mundorf, and this is our Agronomy Focus video. Today I've got with me Tyler Stastny, who is our agronomist out of our Ulysses location.
Yep. You know, covering that area, we have a great stand of corn actually this year, you know, looking at the rest of the country. I'm really excited for the growers that I work with, and you know, getting to that VT time frame, we're looking at a fungicide application. You know, after that tassel comes out, we have those silks. I usually delay about 5 days, and then, you know, I'm right out there. I guess there would be about three types of, three fungicides that I'd like to highlight. I'd like to highlight the Headline Amp, the Trivapro, and the Dolero today.
Yeah. So as you think about those three fungicides, and I know those are all good products, what do you think about as far as those ingredients go and what you're trying to accomplish with each one of them?
So with every fungicide, just like chemistry, you know, there's different actives. Yeah. You know, highlighting the strobes in these particular products, you know, we look at you look at the Trivapro, you look at that oxystrobin, how it's different than the trifoxystrobin in the Dolero, and then you look at the Headline piece, and you look at that pyraclostrobin and how it affects plant health. And they all do it differently, but at the end of the day, they all contribute to yield and they all contribute to plant health.
And to me, it's a two-part conversation with the grower. And as we drove in here today, you know, you're seeing the planes flying. Some of it is fungicide going on corn. Some of it is also insecticide. We've had some issues with thistle caterpillars this year.
Absolutely.
So the planes have already started flying. You know, there's that conversation about how much disease pressure you're seeing. And obviously, it's a no-brainer. I mean, we've had wet weather. If you've got a hybrid that's susceptible to a disease, it's really a no-brainer then to pull the trigger, but a lot of guys are wanting to wait to see disease pressure, and you can't blame them for that. I mean, you've got to have the disease there to really justify the disease side of a fungicide, but like you're talking about on those strobes, they bring another component, you know, slowing that plant metabolism.
Yes, absolutely. You know, so you think about curative and preventative, and the strobes on that preventative side, we want to lower that ethylene production. Ethylene's that hormone that plant produces that advances, you know, senescing or ripening. I like to think about my fruit on the counter. You know, if you're looking at that banana next to, you know, an apple or, you know, whatever you got on that counter, how it might ripen a little bit faster. If we can lower that ethylene production, we can close those stomatas and lower transpiration. We can extend the life of that plant a little bit, and hopefully that's where we're going to capture some of that additional yield. Yep. So
we walked through this field a little bit, and in all honesty, I had to go really to near the bottom of the leaves that hadn't started already senescing to find any disease pressure. I've got just a little bit of gray leaf spot lesion, you know, that really strong rectangle looking. That's how
Absolutely.
I really explain it to guys. It just looks like somebody made a rectangle
That's
out there.
Right.
And you know, we always say nature doesn't make straight lines, but in the case of corn veins, yeah, she does sometimes.
Absolutely. I'm seeing a little bit of northern and a lot of common rust. Down in Kansas, we've already seen some pressure into southern coming in. So, you know, I would definitely keep that in mind as thinking about a fungicide.
So as we talk about gray leaf spot, northern corn leaf blight, I like to kind of get guys focused more looking down in the canopy. But like you mentioned, you talked about common rust and southern rust. Then you want to talk to guys, hey, if you're always looking down for gray leaf spot and northern corn leaf blight, you're not going to see those rusts that have to blow in. Mm-hmm. And so you need to be looking both at the lower leaves like maybe you're used to, but then you got to remember to grab some tops and bring them down and see if you're seeing rust on the top.
Yeah.
And southern's a lot worse than common as far as the yield hit goes.
Absolutely. You know, I'm really excited about this corn this year, and I'm definitely excited about the yield potential. Definitely with some better prices, I've had some guys trying to throw a little bit more at this and definitely maximize our potential out there today.
Very good. Well, thanks for your help today, Tyler.
Yeah.
So thank you for joining us today on our Agronomy Focus video.